Veterans feel legitimately betrayed by the government, who promised to take care of them when they came back from service. And what's happened is the government provides these, you know, VA systems, but the VAs are so in bed with Big Pharma that they're not able to look at any natural alternatives. So alternative treatments tend to be viewed as lower priority, and cannabis is not even in the realm of treatments that they'll endorse at all. So the veterans are being pummeled with all kinds of pharmaceuticals that have very high toxicity, and they've already discovered themselves that cannabis is very effective but also has mild toxicity, if any. And so I think the veterans are starting to question if the government has been lying to them all these years. In the same way that Sanjay Gupta had this moment of enlightenment where he said, my God, I assumed that the government was telling us the truth when they said, when they lumped cannabis into Schedule One with all these much more toxic drugs and they claimed that cannabis had no medical benefit. Dr. Gupta said, I assumed that they were being honest with the public when they claim that cannabis had no medical value. But in fact, he, in further research, he discovered that there was no science to really support the government claims. And we're starting to see the government peeling back things that they've asserted for years. Like, for instance, the DEA has had a report on their website that's claimed that cannabis is, you know, first of all, that documents the gateway theory of cannabis and claims that cannabis leads to much harder drug use. They claim that it causes irreversible psychosis. So suddenly, there was a legal challenge to that report where under the Information Quality Act, there were folks who realized that elected officials are making decisions based on this report on the DEA website. And so they challenged it under the Information Quality Act, and suddenly in the middle of the night, the DEA removed that report that had been there for years. They didn't tell anybody, but people suddenly noticed it. And so I think we're starting to make some headway here where we're challenging the quality of the information that is being submitted by the DEA and other agencies that have a vested interest in keeping prohibition in place.